First of all, thank you everybody for being here. What we want to do is, I was telling Ryan this, and we've been talking about it, is there's a lot of people in Rainbow Jamie that are really new. And because of that, they're still a little lost. You know what I'm saying? When I say lost, they're like going to home and they like... You know, a lot of people in the room, and you Billy, you know, you said, actually got a job, Mr. Franklin. But when you think about a job, what do you think about? You know, to me, yeah, you think about money, it's why you go, right? You leave the people at home you love, and you go, and you drive, and you go spend the whole day with people that you
want
to be around, right? Yeah. And then, you know, hope at the end of the week that you get a check big enough to pay your bills and all that. But I just want you to stop and think just for a second that if you could get good enough at Rainbow to just sell one a week, and you could get good at getting in a home, right? Because see, it's not just about getting good at selling them, it's about getting good at getting in a home, all right? I don't mean getting out knocking doors to get in a home. I'm talking about getting the customers to get you in their friends' homes, right? If you get good at that, and you get good enough to sell just one a week, and you made $5.50 on it, that would keep you from maybe having to go to work those 40, 50 hours, whatever it is, a week that you're maybe doing now, because a lot of us work all week for maybe $5.50 or less, right? And if I can just start selling two a week, now I'm making $1,000 a week, right? And, you know, in my, where do you live where?
Rockingham.
What is that county?
Richmond County.
Richmond County, North Carolina?
Mm-hmm.
What is the average income in Richmond County, North Carolina?
According to Sperling's Best Places, the income per capita is $16,720, which includes all adults and children.
$16,700, you ready? $16,700 divided by 52, $321 a week. That's what the average person in your area makes. Okay? You have a chance to sell two rainbows and make a brand. Okay? The thing, and you know, two sales a week is eight sales a month. Have we ever had anybody win an award here with eight sales a month?
Mm-hmm.
Ever had anybody win an award for selling eight in a month?
GM.
If we ever sold eight in a month and gave somebody an award for that, we're probably almost out of business, okay? Jim sells eight in a week, okay? We're talking eight in a month here, okay? If you can't sell eight in a month, you either A, don't know what you're doing, or B, aren't doing it enough, right?
Yes.
Demos solve all problems. If you show the rainbow enough, and just say you're horrible at it, is anybody horrible at Rainbow? Okay, good. Let's fix it. But if you're horrible at it right now, right? Anything worth being good at is worth being horrible at. If you get what I'm saying, it's worth being horrible. You got to get good. If you just hang, you will. But if you're horrible and you show five to sell one, you need to show how many a week to sell two?
Ten.
You're going to work 30 hours, drive time, everything. Think about that. And that's if you're horrible, right? But nobody in here is really horrible. But what if you start getting good at it where you sell one out of two? You know how many you got to show to sell four or two?
Four.
Okay. You know, so you just got to think about that. And that's what drove me, because I know that if I went and got a regular job somewhere, that they're going to want me to be there certain times, and you know, there's going to be weeks maybe I didn't want to work that hard, or maybe there are weeks I wanted to work harder. It's probably me. I wanted to work more than they would let me work because I wanted to make more money than they wanted to pay me. And so, but then there's that limit. They just won't pay me but so much. You know what I'm saying? And if I got mad and threatened to quit on them, you know what they'd say?
Go ahead, bye, see you later.
There's 100 more just like you out there is what they'd say, and we'll hire them, all right? So, you know, that is kind of a situation when you got a J-O-B, all right? So, but if you got a Y-O-B, you know what a Y-O-B is, right? Your own business, right? And this is your own business, right? You set your own schedule, you determine when you want to work. That's bad and good. How can it be bad? set you on schedule. How could it be bad?
Might not want to work.
You might be lazy, okay? If you're lazy, you need a boss. You need to stay working where you're working, right? Because you wouldn't get up and go, right? And that's the case with anybody. If you open a lawn care business, a hair salon, I don't know what women do business-wise when they go open their own business. But, you know, if you didn't go to work at the hair salon, it wouldn't be successful. You said, I don't feel like going to that. And it's Wednesday, you know, or it's Thursday, you know, or it's Friday when everybody gets their hair done. You say, I don't feel like working. That's Friday. I'm just going to take the day and sit by the pool, okay? You know, that's great, but you wouldn't be successful. So in this, just like anything, you got to be disciplined and do these, all right? If you do these, you can, there's two ways to learn to do this, you know. They're all the same, but there's two ways. Go do demos and get the experience that way. Or come to meetings and do demos, and you'll get the experience quicker. So guess what will happen to your closing average? A little quicker. It'll go up quicker, right? But I don't have any doubt, Jamie. Listen, you figure it out. If you never came to another meeting and you just went and did a bunch of demos, you'd figure it out. You would. I don't know how long it'd take you. It might take you 6 months or 8 months. You'd figure it out. True, Philip, figure it out. I think people would just figure it out, don't you?
Yes.
So, but I can really hurry that process along if you're coming to meetings. And I'm talking, I want you. Do you mind, Phil, just talk about the meetings, what they did for you?
Sure.
Because when you first started, you struggled a little bit?
Well, struggled a lot.
Struggled a lot? Okay.
Because I was...
In what way?
Well, I was... you don't sell, but you demo. But at the end of the day, you actually are selling yourself. And I was used to people saying yes to me because...
Your other job.
My other job, everybody told me yes. So they had to, which cost them money severely. So I wasn't used to no's. You taught me used to getting no's. And how to overcome the no's, and how to prevent getting a no, because you end up, what you end up learning in this in advanced training is that they will, you kind of stop the no before they actually come out.
Which we're going to cover at the very end.
Which is what is really important. You want to overcome the no's. Because once you get a no, and they know they can get away with saying no's, you're in trouble. And the training actually helps you eliminate those as you do your demo. And I used to go, if you were open, I did a demo. You were open, and I wasn't doing a demo, I was here training. Right. It would be two times. I went through the basic training two times just to hear it again.
I got people never been at one time.
But I went through it twice.
You went through it twice?
Because I wanted to do to learn.
How
really
far do we live from you? How long does it take you to drive here?
45 minutes.
One way.
Just sounds true.
But you just gotta want to. Now, look, if your schedule's where you can't. We're not throwing stones at you.
But then there's a video.
But if you can, please do. You know, it will pay off. And how long? And I'll be honest, Philip, if he didn't come to a meeting tonight, he'd still be pretty good at Rainbow tomorrow, right? It's just like riding a bike. I don't have to go back and learn somebody, you know, somebody hold the back seat again, push me again, teach me again. I learned that a long time ago. You know, now, don't get me wrong, we sharpened Philip up tonight.
Yeah, my, right? My first demo, if I could, took me 6 hours.
6 hours.
Now it takes me the normal 2 hours to go in and out. And my closing ratio was pretty...
How about keeping the customer's attention better?
Well, yeah. And they don't want to throw you out.
Right. Better now.
But everybody was nice. But my first demo solo was 6 hours. For real.
Well, we can help with that. And everybody's first demo is probably longer, right? Let's hope it was. You know, 5 hours over here. Okay. It's all right. Yeah, just trying to figure it out. So, anyway... That's why you're here, I think. But how do you get in a home? Listen, there's a couple ways you can get in a home, because you asked me this, how do I get in a home, right? Well, listen, it's kind of a good thing that you don't know anybody around. Okay? Because a lot of us hate showing people we know. You know what I mean? Okay? So, but you got to figure out how to get in a home. There's several different ways. It's not just, I will tell you the best way to get in a home. Best way to get in a home. You remember that demo we all three went on, guys? You know why that rainbow sold that night? You know why we sold that rainbow that night that everybody would be on? I'm going to tell you what happened at the very end. At the very end, well, not very, but at the kind of the beginning, but anyway, it translated to the very end. At the very beginning when I said, have you ever seen a rainbow before? Do you remember what she said? She said, yeah. I've been borrowing Erin's rainbow. I'm sorry, I've been using her rainbow at her house. I'm sorry. I love it. How freaking hard do you think that sale was? She's already using the lead person's rainbow before I... That rainbow was sold before I ever walked in the home. And I, you know, and I drove home, I said to myself, hey, you still got it, baby. No, but I know the reality of it was the lead sold itself, but I got paid. Okay? So, come on in, guys. And so, the best lead is an owner lead. An owner lead. You know what I'm talking about? The lead person that sent you to this house tonight bought one. Best lead on the planet. You agree, Maya? You love to be there, right? Okay. Somebody saw one. I'm trying to think who it was. She's not here. But she was on an owner lead last night, right? And I said, how do you know such and such? She says, well, my wife knows her. And I said, well, she loves her rainbow. I said, do you know such and such? Because I know another one that was connected. Yeah, I know. Yeah, they bought one too. Then that helped or hurt?
The Joneses.
Oh, my gosh. And that's a saying. But in rainbow lives, it is unbelievable how that works. Okay? Somebody told me the other day, Jim did, that he saw one and a guy said, I'm not buying. The reason the guy ended up, he finally told him why he was saying no, is because I bet my buddy $25 I wouldn't buy it. Jim said, I'll give you the $25. Don't let that keep you from getting it. And the wife said, oh, honey, that's stupid. The guy's not going to make you pay him anyway. Let's get it. And they bought it. But you're saying, what happened? Here's the conversation. You're going to buy it tonight when you see it. You're going to buy it just like we did. You're going to buy it. No, I'm not spending $2,000 on a stupid back. You're an idiot. What did he do? Went to work? Yeah, we bought one. Okay, the next day. Okay, you get what I'm saying. It's that doesn't happen on a cold lead. Does anyone know what a cold lead is?
Yes.
Here's a cold lead. A registration, a home show lead. You don't know what that is yet. But a lead that has no connection to anyone else. Have you ever had this happen to you? You ever seen a rainbow before, Mrs. Jones? I've never heard of it. Huh? You've never heard of a rainbow? And I've heard of a Kirby. Is it like a Kirby? Okay. You ever had that happen to you? Okay. Well, yeah. All right. That's a pretty tough one to sell. Compared to, yeah, my mom keeps bragging about her rainbow she bought last week from me. Okay? You get what I'm saying? The best lead to be on is an owner green light. Okay? And, you know, Chris always, and I don't know if Chris has already been followed up with her. In fact, you sent me a demo you sent today. Mm-hmm. Was that from her?
Yes.
Okay. What'd you do? Did you call her back?
I did.
Tell us what you did. You sold one yesterday. Didn't get any green lights.
I didn't get any green lights. She wanted the shampoo and the mop, so I called her back. Asked her if she had any luck with getting anybody, and she gave me one person and told me that she was at work, so I went ahead and called her at work and set it up for tomorrow.
Did she own her? She told her she bought one.
She told her she bought one. Yeah.
You know what she's curious about? She bought. Tomorrow when he's in her home, if he does his thing, I know he'll mention her name several times, she'll be sitting there thinking about, this is what she bought. See, it's not him demoing, it's her demoing it. Like, that way. Does that make sense? It really does change the meaning of everything. I was going to ask you something. Oh, why does she want the shampoo and the mop?
Because she loved it and she wants to get it for free instead of paying for it.
No, why does she want it, though?
Get her house clean. Yeah. Get all the other dirt out.
What?
Because he showed it.
He showed it to him.
Yeah.
When you did you show it to
yes.
one?
Always.
Look, guys, this is a shampoo.
I demoed it.
Oh, you shampoo.
Yes.
Okay, so they wouldn't have wanted it had you not used it.
No.
Because I'll be honest with you, that shampoo right here to me, it don't look too impressive. It does not look impressive. Look at this thing, guys. This is a shampoo. You can get this free before people. All right. Okay. If that's all you're going to do, you're never going to get great people working for that. Okay? I mean, I want my customers working for that bread to the point that if they can't get four people, they're calling me backing out on the sale. Jay, we were going to keep the rainbow, but now we can't get that shampoo, we can't get four people. We don't want rainbow at all. Because the only reason we bought it is that shampoo. I wanted it that bad. See, that's how they need to feel about the shampoo or the mop. You know? But you got to wet the carpet. You can't just show it to them. In the time it takes me to describe, you put water in this side, shampoo over here, and you put this on here right here. Now, what you got here is your paddle. And this one right here is the dry cycle, turns out. And what you can do there is it dries. But anyway, right in the middle, this is the dry cycle. Okay? This is the wet cycle. Anyway, so I'm going to go through it. And you look down on the bottom, what you got these bristles that turn. It's really easy to clean up. You just pull that out, wash all that out. The front plate comes up. By the time I did all of that, I could have. And you know what sells this shampooer?
The black
water.
When you get done and you show them the black water, you believe all that was in your pocket? Isn't that crazy? And then you tell them the white shirt story, which I know y'all know. If you don't, you should watch the video. You got to show the gifts. That's one way to get them. Second way to get in a home is, or another way to get in a home is registration. All right? Here's what registration is. It's door to door. It's really simple. Now, only people who are special can do this. All right? So if you're not a special person, you can't do this. I mean, your mama probably thinks you're special. Okay? But if you're special, right, Chris? You're special, right? In a couple ways. You're
special. That's right.
Here's what I mean. Anybody can do this. You just got to, we gonna do it. Did anybody ever sell Girl Scout cookies or things in school and stuff like that? You know? Did anybody ever knock the neighborhood?
Yes.
Did you do that?
Yes.
I heard you did one time. Was it you?
Yeah.
What was it you were selling?
Well, it depends on which one I was in at the point in time.
But you knocked the neighborhood, didn't you?
Yeah, marching band. We were selling pizzas and cookies and fruits and, yeah, everything.
I'll never forget when I was young, and I don't know how to, I was probably 12 or 13, but my mom and dad, I got home, and the police was in the driveway. They called the law because they thought something happened to me because I went door knocking in my neighborhood selling the stuff for school. That's a fact, okay? I just knocked on the doors and said, hey, I'm selling this. Are you interested in me? But look, there's nothing wrong. I lived and I came back home and everything's still okay. You know, it's okay. And look, I'm not going to go to Cracktown doing this.
Right?
Right? It's Cracktown. They can't get a rainbow finance anyway. So I'm not going to go to the rich neighborhoods either. I'm going to go to average homes, right? So anyway, I just go to the door and I say, hey, how are you? Good. Don't worry, I'm not selling anything today. What our company's doing, we're just letting everybody know about our company. We're in the area. What we do is we sell products that clean and purify the air in people's homes. If anybody has allergies, asthma, COPD. One of the machines we sell down at the store, where?
Yeah.
We sell these down at the store. Is this little air purifier right here that uses water? You know, like when it rains outside, how fresh the air smells?
Yes,
that's what it does to the air in your home. It water washes the air with no filters. And I know you have a dog. What I like too is you put fragrances in. I have a dog too. Helps with pet odors, cooking odors. Anyway, I work for the company. And what we're doing, we're giving away 8 of these in a little drawing tonight at 6 just to get the word out that we're in the area. The only thing we ask, if you win one, that you just tell everybody how much you love it. And we're located. Our address down at the bottom. And I'll put you in the drawing. What's your name?
Lewis.
Okay. And your last name?
Brewster.
Okay. The best number reached. We're doing a drawing at 6.
910-638.
That's what I do. And thank you. Good luck. That's what I do. That's what I do. I go to doors that say no soliciting.
That's how I got a retreat.
Yeah. I was knocking on the door that says no soliciting. I read your sign. Don't worry. I'm not selling anything. We're just handing out cards. How hard is that? You know, Philip, we ever get in your nose?
Yeah.
Sometimes people are just unhappy. And you happen to knock on the door, you know, and they're going to be unhappy with you, all right? So that's okay. Let's go to the next door, right? And we call these people that we register, and we let them know, hey, do you remember Billie Jean, a lady named Billie Jean was by your house earlier today and registered for a free air purifier that our company is giving away? Well, great, I have some good news. You've been selected tonight as a winner. Congratulations to you. Right, well, what do we need to do? Just line a time up for Billie Jean, the lady who's out there, and I'm paraphrasing all this, to just drop it out to you and install it and explain how to use it. She needs a little bit of counter space and outlet, and we need a little bit of water out of your faucet. And we're delivering all these gifts tomorrow and Saturday. So tell us what day will work best. And by the way, we do have to catch both you and your husband there just for safety purposes. We can't come in unless both of you go home. Would tomorrow work better or Saturday? Okay, great. Tomorrow. Okay, what time are you going to do it? Just, like I said, both of you need to be there. We have 4 o'clock, we have 5 o'clock, and we have 6 o'clock available.
5.
5 o'clock, gotcha. Okay, great. And I don't think we have your address. Let me get your address. Okay, great. What's your spouse's name? Okay, great. All right, well, we got everything we need. Again, congratulations. You love our little air purifier. We love ours. We put eucalyptus in it. It's good for vaporizing when our kids are sick, blah, blah, blah. And insurance is absolutely free. Now, the only thing our company does ask in order for Billie Jean to get credit for dropping it off and kind of that's how she gets paid. When she comes out, that you guys let us do a real quick presentation on the whole house unit called the Rainbow E2V. And it just what it does, it cleans all the air in your home. She just has to do a real quick presentation on that while she's there, and that way she'll get credit and get paid. Would that be okay? Great. All right, well, we will see you then tomorrow at 5 o'clock. Congratulations. How hard is that? Nothing to it. Okay. Now, the other way we get in homes is Rainmate boxes. All right, I don't have one. Turns out we've used every one of them. We got some ordered. But like in my dental office, I know the, I've been using the same dentist for a long time. And me and the receptionist, she used to work at the bank that we deal with. So we know, I know Patty really well, right? She bought Rainbow and all this stuff. So anyway, when we got the boxes out, I called Patty and said, "Hey, Patty, you know, I sell Rainbows. How you doing?" Anyway, we came up with this new air purifier. And if it was a doctor's office that you are just going to, say, "Hey, how are you? Good. Are you the office manager? Great. Let me just talk to you real quick. I work for Rainbow, and Rainbow just came up with this tabletop air purifier. And what we're doing, we're just trying to get the word out in the area about it. And what the company's letting us do is let us put several in the area, doctors, dentists, chiropractors, veterinarian offices, in waiting rooms, and they get to use them free of charge for up to 90 days, okay? And at the end of the 90 days, we just come pick it up and take it out of here. But what this thing does, it does a couple things. Number one, it cleans the air, and also it puts humidity out. And what I like, too, is it would freshen up. You put fragrances in, and it actually freshens up, and I don't know, your lobby kind of has a smell. Mm-hmm. So this would actually help that smell. And the only thing we ask is that somebody here in the office change the water about once a week, right? And then I'll come by, Tara, just once a week, change the water too, okay? And like I said, it's a $250 unit, but you don't have to buy, it's yours to use. And again, one more thing we do need, we're going to put a little box next to it and let your customers register, because our goal is to get 150 of these in the area. So we're giving them away to some of the people in the area. So that'd be okay. And they'd say yes or no, right? And then you place the box here. So you've seen the registration boxes in restaurants and stuff. This is going to say register for a free air purifier. It's sitting next to the air purifier that's running, right? And right in front of it is a clipboard with the pin on a chain and some entries. So they just fill out the entry, drop it in while they're sitting in the waiting room. So they're sitting there watching the water, and the water's starting to get them in a trance, and so then they register and they win one, right? The very first one we sold off my dentist, we sold 2 in 1 ounce.
Wow.
Not me, but another guy sold 2 in 1 ounce off the box, okay? You ever sold a box, Lee?
Yep.
Yep. How many?
Half a dozen at least.
Half a dozen at least. How many boxes you got?
2.
Another option, okay? Don't put them where the wrong people go. No, I wouldn't put them in a tattoo place. I wouldn't put them in a, I just wouldn't do it.
Welfare.
You heard of tattoos.
You ever been in a tattoo place?
No, never.
Yeah. Well, then you know why not to put one there, okay? Though you're,
horrible. There's, those people have a lot of money, believe it or not. I was going to say, yeah. You get a tattoo, you got money.
But anyway, you know what I'm saying, you wouldn't want to put one in a convenience store. You wouldn't want to put one in a, in maybe a doctor's office that takes Medicaid, you know. Like a chiropractor is a good place, a dry cleaner, a veterinarian, where people go that have just a dog groomer, where people have a little bit of extra money, but they also aren't, I mean, we put one in a bar. You get what I'm saying. You're just going to get the wrong people registering, all right? And has I ever been in a tattoo park? No. But I can imagine there's some good people in there, right?
Yeah.
Right? Because I've seen
definitely.
Some people, most everybody has a tattoo now, right? But you do get a lot of bad stuff too in there, of course.
Yeah.
You know that. So they're here to get something else pierced this week. So, I don't know why you're laughing. It wasn't supposed to be funny. I was just making a snake. Okay. What are you thinking about? All right. So, any questions? That's another way, all right? Another way, we do home shows, all right? We're getting ready to do the Southern Women's Show this weekend. You ever heard of that? No. It's in Charlotte. It's a show. You ever heard of the Southern Spring Show? No, it's in Charlotte.
It's like Christmas
Show. Southern Christmas Show. Okay. We can't do the Christmas show because we're not a craft. They won't let anything in. It's not a craft. But we tried. But it's the same company. It's the same
thing. We can suck up craft.
Huh?
We can suck up the craft.
Yeah. But what we do is we have a booth there with all the boxes, all the Rainmates lined up. We have these special boxes underneath them with lights that shine up through the water. And so the Rainmates are running on these lights, and it says 150 to be given away at this show, register for one. So then people come through and they register for the free air purifier. And we're standing out front putting mulberry in, letting them smell them, and they're, oh, I love that. You know, that would help. I have pets. And then they register, and we call them and let them know they won. And then, of course, after we let them know they won, then we put, the only way we can deduct this off our taxes is if you guys let us do a real quick Rainbow presentation while we're there. Is that okay? Because our booth says Rainbow. They know it was Rainbow. So we're getting ready to do the Southern Women's Show starting tomorrow. And some of you guys may get offered a demo from there, right? So if you do get offered a demo from there, just know that they're watching the demo for what reason?
To
Because they want an air purifier, right? So when you go tomorrow, on that demo, sorry, when you go on that demo, you're going to take a brand new Rainmate wrapped up in the plastic. Okay, this is it. Okay, but you leave it in the car. That is theirs, all right? What I'm going to take to the door is my demo Rainmate and my demo case. I go in, I'm going to warm up and all this, and at some point in the warm up, I'm going to say, now, what did my company tell you I'd be doing here tonight, Shane?
Don't we be washing
that
Rainmate?
Well, she's going to say this, just dropping off our air purifier with you. What else did they tell you I was going to be doing here tonight? Well, they said something about a presentation or something, right? Okay, so I want to make sure you understood. Yeah, in order for us to write this off on our taxes, the air purifier you won, I do have to do a real quick presentation of the whole house unit. You don't have to buy it or anything like that, but I get credit or I kind of get paid to do that. So that helps me. But let's step into your kitchen. Let me show you what you won. Then I'm going to get into the kitchen. I'm going to hook up my demo Rainmate, and I'm going to go through my Rainmate and get them real excited about it, right? And then I'm going to tell them, yours is in the car. I'm going to run and get it. But I'll tell you what my company lets me do. I can actually give you two more of these if what? If you can get me four other people to watch a demo like you're doing tonight, okay? So, and then of course we're going to make our list of names. How could we bribe them to give us the names?
Fragrances.
The names. You're right. You could. That's different than what I was thinking, but you could.
Vacation.
You could give them the vacation. Yeah. And our company also lets me give you this 3-day, 2-night vacation. You're out to get a Myrtle Beach, Captain Burger, and I go through and explain, get them excited about it. If you can give me a list of 8 names tonight, I give you this. Okay. So who'd be the first person? I'm going to get my list of names, then once they're qualified, find out owner rent and all that stuff, chart white copy and all that, and give it to them, and then I go over script and say, call 4 people now, and I get you 2 of these, I'm going to run and get your air purifier out of the car. And the Rainmate. I get the air purifier and the Rainmate come back in, right? Got me? Okay.
Yep.
So it's just a little different deal, but it's the same thing, okay? Anybody in here off of a home show? Is that how we got in your home, Philip?
Mm-hmm.
Home show?
Mm-hmm.
You're off of a home show? Which home show were you off of?
Joe.
Joe's home show. You're right. He did it. Yeah. You were at the Southern Spring Show two years ago, yeah. Larry Cole was a registration where I knocked on his door in 1993. You know what I mean? So, how does stuff work? Well, it all works. You just got to be willing to do it. You know? And I always say, so I'll try that. No, don't try it. It'll try you. Okay? You just do it. Just do it, right? How many of you sold registrations, Chris?
I don't know, quite a few.
Maya, was your last sale a registration?
Yep.
Class A, free rainbow?
Free rainbow.
She sold her free rainbow on a registration. Maya is 17, and she went on a registration, okay? Have you ever registered, Maya? We got to get you out to register next.
Yeah,
that's the next
thing.
Okay. So anyway.
She's been doing it for 7 years.
Okay, so that's how you get into home. So if you're wondering, I don't know how to get into home. Get into home. Let me ask, there's my pen right there. I knew it was close
enough. It's falling down.
I mean, I knew it was close
enough. That's why you need a few more calories to hold it.
So, I can't gain weight, right? She can't gain weight probably either. Well, she is now. It's genetic.
You gain weight the way she's gaining weight, we'll call it.
Yeah. A little different for kids after people sell it.
Hey, Mike, did you get that? No, home? Catch me. So anyway, we got that figured. There's one more thing you can do to get in a home. Do you have lead sheets from your previous demos?
Yes.
Like the sheets?
Yes. Yeah.
They're not green lights, but the ones that they never called or whatever?
Yeah.
Call them.
Yeah, now I've called those several times.
Okay. When I call them, and I could ask you what you said, but I want to put you on the spot.
I said the script.
Said the script.
I went by exactly what you said.
The non-green light script?
Whatever it applied to, I went by almost word for word.
Perfect. All right, awesome. This is kind of how I would say Jamie, and we'll say Chris and Joe is the person that gave the list of names, and now I'm calling Jamie. And I'll just call her and you answer. Hey, is this Jamie?
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, Jamie, how are you?
Okay, how are you?
Good. Hey, my name is Jamie. So we got to fix that. We got to get on the train. And, you know, like a lot of us rushed through these trainings. Some of you didn't even come. Is there anybody came all 3 days? All 3 days in a row?
Of which?
In a row.
The
technician trainers.
All right.
Yeah? Okay. So, I mean, that helps so much if you come to the training. Okay, so does anyone have the video?
Yeah.
the DVD. I didn't want to ever. Okay, good. Thank you. All right, good. Because that really helps a lot too. So, but anyway, hey, let me ask you this real quick. Just remind me.
No, I haven't talked to her.
You haven't talked to her today? Okay, I bet I probably beat her to you. Well, let me explain what's going on. I'm sorry about that. I was out in their house. How do you know them?
They're
church. Okay, they're awesome people. We were at their home the other night and done a real quick rainbow demonstration. Anyway, Chris is trying to win an air purifier that our company just came out with, a little rain-made air purifier. It's new, and Rainbow just came out with it. It's $200. She's got an opportunity to win it for free just by getting four friends and relatives to do a demo like they did the other night. Mm-hmm. And once she gets four people to look a demo for her, and she gets the air purifier absolutely free. And I guess she gave me your name because she felt like, I guess, maybe you'd help her out, you know, since you're a church family member, and we always try to help each other at our church. But just for watching, if you could do that for Chris, I do get to give you a free vacation. You get to Myrtle Beach and Gatlinburg, stay 2 nights free in a Holiday Inn, Holiday Express, or Fairfield by Marriott, and you get that absolutely free just for helping her out. And don't worry, I realize you probably have a good vacuum and you're not interested, but it helps Chris and Joe. Would you mind just doing that for them? I mean, you would really mean a lot to them if you would.
Sure.
Okay, great. Now, I'm going to be in your ear tomorrow or Saturday. Now, I have to catch both you and your husband, so would tomorrow work better or Saturday catch both of you?
Tomorrow.
That's all I got to do. All right. Well, I get a no sometimes.
Yep.
But I'll get a lot more, I'll get yeses, personally, more than I'll get no. Because I kind of learned what to say. I realize you already got a good vacuum, and you ain't got to buy a vacuum. All right, I don't even have to show the price. But if you do it for Joe and Chris, it would really mean a lot to Chris. Because you know their daughter's got allergies. So it'd help them out. So, but anyway, would you mind doing it for them? Would you help her out? Great. I'm not going to buy one. Well, good. That's fine. You got a Dyson? Well, they're awesome. Great. We know you don't need a vacuum then. Say that crap on the phone. When I get out there, she'll probably feel different. Right?
Yeah.
But if I never get
in the home, you can't show them.
I can't show them the difference. Right? Okay. Tina, anyway, but that's how you get in a home. Will you do it? I don't know. I'll tell you this. She's going to work somewhere.
Right.
She's going to work somewhere. This is a lot better deal to me than working anywhere else. But you're going to work somewhere. Okay. So the difference here is nobody's going to fire you if you don't come to work. Nobody's going to fire you if you don't have a great attitude today. Nobody's going to fire you if you ain't really motivated today. Right? You just kind of don't get paid. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, all right. Okay. Of all the ways I just showed you get in a home, the easiest way is what?
Green lights.
The green lights. It's by far the easiest way to get in a home. They've already said yes. Instead of me having to call and talk Jamie into doing it, if I just get Chris to call her, she'll say yes a lot quicker for Chris than she would me. She's going to see Chris at church Sunday.
Yep.
She don't want to be having that awkwardness. I'm sorry I couldn't help you out. I wouldn't do it. You know, I mean, she's going to be like, okay, I got to do it. You know, she's going to have to get off the phone. Honey, we got to do this. I know you don't want them to come over here, but I've told her, and you know, I go to church with her, and we got to do this, okay? I mean, that's all the same thing. That's what happens, right? So, okay, so let's talk about how to sell a rainbow. How about that? So when you go in a home, and I'll tell you, anybody that can sell a rainbow does this, all right? There's seven things that will help you. I always call them the seven keys to success. I'll just write them up here for you. Did I spell everything right? Number one, most important thing to do when you're doing a demo is to ask a lot of questions to your customer. Number two, number three, vary your voice.
Barry.
First names. Most important four right there, hands down. Number five, I think, would be gestures. I talk with my face and hands. Okay. I also talk fast. Why does talking fast help?
Keeps them interested.
It does.
If you they gotta concentrate and
keep. It looks like you're in a what?
Hurry.
People like it when you're in a hurry.
Gives them the sense of urgency.
Gives them the sense that you're not gonna be here long. Right? Mm-hmm. Well, I know, man. You go in there and lay back in your chair and start reading that book. Oh my God! They think, you look at all those pages. Yeah. And number seven. Anybody know what it is?
Yeah.
Everybody in the back does. Okay. Give me a second. I got to look at it and see which one I have.
Compliment?
Yeah, eye contact's pretty much common sense if you don't look at your customer. But I have had dealers in here that had that eye contact problem. They can't look somebody in the eye when they talk to them. Because that's a nervous problem. More than, you know, so I think it's like stuttering or something like that. So sometimes you can't do that. But, okay, if you will do that, you will sell rainbows. All right? We can stop the meeting right here, and this is worth driving for if you will do that. But I will also tell you this, Tara, that if you go in a home and you don't do this, but you do a textbook demonstration, you will not sell rainbows. If you don't do that, and you do a textbook, thorough, awesome demo, you will not sell rainbows. You'll sell one every now and again. Right? The problem with that is, you went through everything, but you bored the crap out of them.
Mm-hmm.
And they fell asleep.
They wanted you out there now so bad.
Correct. I've been on demos and people have said, and I've never had this said to me, thank God, but I have had to be right under people, and the customer say, I'm not trying to be rude, but how much longer is this demo going to take? It ain't because we want to go ahead and buy it right now. When the hell are you leaving? I mean, that's how. So look, you got to learn to do this. I had a guy that come in. He's a pharmacist. We recruited him when he bought his rainbow. Right? This guy said, "This is his words," and I loved it because he's an intelligent guy. He's a pharmacist, and he's a foreigner, like maybe from somewhere in the Middle East. Right? So real touch. He says, Jay, let me tell you, I saw a rainbow less than a year ago. Bye. And he told me the guy's name, and I knew the guy. And I said, he said, no, I'll tell you what, that was awful. He said he was unbelievable. He read every page of that book, guys. He said we were just wore out when he left. But Brian didn't do that. Brian came out, it was exciting, entertaining, and we bought it. People want an action movie. They don't want a documentary. You know, number one movie? Something like Iron Man or Fantastic Four or Godzilla. I don't know. Star Wars. It's not actually a good movie. It's something action-packed crap. Okay? That's what people want. Right? This makes your demo action-packed. Not a documentary. So, focus on this. As you see me do this tonight, I want you to watch those things that I'm doing. Because honestly, I straight up, you ready? I can sell a pee out of these machines and do a shoddy demo. I do with that right there. You might be with Jim, saw your own demo? How many times does he get up out of the chair? Or does he?
Probably doesn't.
He goes to the kitchen cap, kitchen
table. That's it. So he doesn't get up out of his chair throughout the whole day. No lie, because he physically. But I'm going to tell you what, he keeps their attention. And he gets commitments and he asks tons of questions and he calls them by their first names. He's got them eaten out of his hand, right? And you know, while we're talking about Jim, he made 13 grand last month. Yeah. Okay. So he's got 30 years of experience. If he's not any good by now, something would be wrong, right? So 30 years. If you do anything for 30 years, you got to be good. So let's just talk about when you first walk in home, you're going to be dressing up like crap. So let's say you've done all that. And you know, when I get ready to start the demo, I'm going to put the coffee table where, Chris?
On the side.
Over there. I move the coffee table. And I know people don't always have coffee tables now, but I say, can I get you help me slide this down, guys? Tom, would you help me? You got to get up. He's going to move the coffee table. Help me. So I put it over here, right? And what am I laying on top of my table? I ask him, do you mind if I set the stuff on your coffee table, underneath your coffee table? It'll make my demo go a lot quicker. What do you think they're going to say if I say to make my demo go off?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, sure. Anything to make the demo go quick, whatever. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool. And so I put it all underneath here, and I put my 30 black cloths on top, and they're all clean. So every time I need a cloth, what do I do? Watch this, guys. I don't have to sit here. Anybody have a problem getting these things apart?
Yes.
Think about the time you're wasting doing that. If you could go ahead and know, okay, I'm going to need two for the upholstery brush they're putting together. I'm going to need two more for the upholstery brush they're putting together. See, I can't even get them apart. I mean, why not get your crap together and ready so that when you get ready to grab two, you've got two, right? And put your stacks of twos over here. Anyway, get ready. What am I sitting on? If you've ever been at home, they didn't have a chair. I mean, you experienced that on that demo, right? Didn't have a chair. If I were doing Rainbow for a living, I would have a chair in my car. You can buy one of these at Walmart, Sam's, like, I don't know, $12. Put it in the trunk of your car, put everything on top of it. But when you need it, I got a chair. This house in here is a nightmare. There's no chair, right? The one we went to, they had a kitchen table with the bar stools. I can't sit on a bar stool and do the demo. I can't reach the, I know Tony can't reach the floor. Right? His feet even dangle, right? So, okay.
Sit on the bar.
Huh?
Sit on the bar.
I know. You want to be close to the floor, right? I do too. I want to be eye level. So do it. And I've got rainbow wear. And I want the kid over here, right? And I already get my water out of the sink while they're calling, right? By the way, you know you speak to your green lights, right? So you're popping back and forth in the kitchen, talking to the green lights, and doing what? Setting them, mm-hmm. Right? Find out what kind of vacuum, make sure husband watches, set the time of day, right? Okay, so we did all that. Now we're ready to start the rainbow demo. And by the way, how quick do you need to get through the rainmate? You need to learn how to do the rainmate quick, and get your green lights quick, and get to the rainbow quick. What's the problem if that takes 2 hours? They're wore out, and you hadn't even said, in fact, humans need 3 things to live yet. And they're wore out. You know what I mean? You ever had that happen to you, Philip? I know I have.
Yes.
I was wore out. Dang, I got to do the demo. I'm already tired. And I ain't even brought the rainbow out of the box yet. So, anyway, let me get over here to the very beginning of this book. It might take me a couple minutes. Bear with me, please. All right, cool. By the way, when I go through this book, guys, isn't this book awesome? It tells you what to do, right? But when I go through this book, if I sit here and read every letter, what's going to happen? They are, right? You know we used to do demos before there was demo books? We did. We went and talked. You know, I'm not trying to get you not to use a book, because the book's awesome, right? But what I am trying to get you not to do is read to them. Right? And I'm going to show you what reading to them looks like. You ready, guys? We're ready to start. All right. It's the fact that humans need 3 things to live. Clean food, clean water, clean fresh air. It's the fact that each day you will breathe several hundred cubic feet of air. Pure air, or clean pure air, is just as important as clean food or clean water. Do you or your members of your household occasionally suffer from headaches, irritated eyes, coughing, sore throat, dizziness, nausea, and nasal discharge, dizziness? I don't know what that is. I never got dizzy. But polluted air may respond for these symptoms. I'm just saying, though, I'm going to sit here and read to them about it. Jay, I did the demo just the way you trained me, and I didn't sell it. Common sense. Your customer is bored. Okay? Your customer's bored. You're not going to make a sale tonight. They're going to actually leave, right? So you got to balance the information with the entertainment, enthusiasm, right? You got to figure it out, right? I got to tell the story because this makes sense, I think. When I was in college and took a speech class, they asked us to watch a famous speech and dissect it and tell us what patterns, what habits, what did this presenter say in the speech that made it a memorable speech? And they gave us a list, and we had to pick from the list, you know. And the one I watched it, and I said, this guy keeps repeating the same line over and over. You get what I'm saying? Has anyone ever heard a speech like that? Can you think of one?
Yeah.
I have a dream. Everybody always comes up with that one, right? How many times has Martin Luther King? And Obama, and that, you might be an Obama fan, doesn't matter. But in his State of the Union this year, he kept on saying, pass the bill. Over and over and over. He kept on saying, pass the bill. You know? And see, because he is a very good presenter, right? You may not like him. He's a very good presenter, okay? You want to be a very good presenter in this business, guys. And I'm going to tell you, this is the demo dissected. Just like I dissected that speech, there it is. If you want to know how to act like somebody really knows what the heck they're doing in Rainbow, do those right there. They're going to think, this guy's great. Dang, man. He's rocking it, you know? So, but I'll let me do the demo without the book. Just a second. You want to do that? All I need is this right here. I just need that page. All right. All right, we're going to get started. All right, guys, I don't want to bore you. I ain't going to stay too long with you here tonight. But let me, first of all, start out with just saying that we don't think about it. But you know, we got to have three things in there. We've got to have food, got to have water, right? And we got to have air, right? Now, we can go days without eating anything. Actually, weeks without eating anything. Days without drinking anything. But how long can you hold your breath? So air is pretty important, right? The reason we don't think about it is because our bodies breathe automatically for us, right, Jamie? Okay. Let me ask you this. Can you turn that fan on? Just to plug it or something. I'll sweat through this thing. I'm in a trailer tonight with no air conditioning. You ever been there?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Dirty diapers later.
Mm-hmm.
Flies fine, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cockroaches.
Yeah, they're smoking.
Yeah.
20 minutes.
No fan on.
Right. Strip when you get home in the yard before you go in the house.
The wife is wearing a no bra and a tank top.
I don't know about that. But anyway, but I say, guys, let me ask you a question. Do you have a problem? Which one are you?
Which one?
Yeah. Pam?
No,
I'm
Beth.
Okay.
I'll go by Pam if you want me to.
You're Beth. You're Pam. Yes. Okay, gotcha, PB. Okay. I got you. All right. Sorry. Okay. So, Pam, let me ask you a question. Would you have a problem breathing the air between my hand and my eye?
Would I have a problem breathing?
The air between my hand and my eye.
No.
Nothing. No.
How about now?
Yeah.
See all that? Pam, can you see that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what they're talking about when they say house dust. Of course, she probably seen that in, like, see the sunlight comes through the window.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. And you're closed the window real quick, or blind real quick, so you don't have to look at it anymore. Okay.
Cat
I was
fur.
In a lady's house, huh?
Cat fur.
Cat fur, yeah. Yeah, animals.
Dog hair.
I was in a lady's house the other night, and she looked at me, she said, well, how's that in my ear? I've seen it before. I said, well, think about this. When you walk across the carpet, look what happens to the stuff that's in the floor. It just boils out of the floor, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. And you know, once you stir it up, you know, they stay. Say it stays in air for purpose. Mm-hmm. We're always moving around, so what do we always keep? We always keep it kicked out, okay? Mm-hmm. Well, let me ask you this. Have you ever stepped in a bubble gum out in the parking lot?
Mm-hmm.
I hate that, don't you? You know what that proves? People don't look where they walk. People don't look where they spit, right? We walk out here in the parking lot and people spit you in the back. And we're unhealthy people clear their throats. Did you go to work today?
Yes, I did.
Unless you held it for 8 hours, you probably went in a public restroom. did you take your shoes off before you walked in? Mm-hmm. There's things on that public restroom floor from germs, viruses, hepatitis. Who knows? Sometimes that water ain't always water.
Mm-hmm.
And did you take your shoes off before you came to your home? See, I know I didn't. See, a lot of things we walk through, man, you know where to end up? They end up in our home.
Yeah,
and our coming off our shoes. Exactly. So when we walk across this stuff, you know what we're actually breathing? That bacteria, those germs. Remember that guy's urine? I say that in some homes. I don't say that. Okay. I do, okay? Some homes you do, Shelby. Some homes you don't, right? You know the difference, right?
You know who you can and can't.
You know who you, I mean, hopefully you can figure that out. So, but what am I doing here? I'm talking to you. Am I reading from a book? But I'm making good eye contact. I'm using your first names. I'm right. Where am I?
Right.
I'm in your grill, man. You got to be right up here at them. If you can't touch your customer, and I do touch my customer all the time. I'm leaving my pen. I do that a lot, okay? Why do I do that?
Get their attention.
Get their attention, exactly. Okay, because I only got one shot at this. Mm-hmm. I ain't coming back. And there's a lot of jobs out here in the world, but I got the best one. But I got to be good at it, okay? I got to be awesome at it, right? And, you know, listen, you get on an airplane, you expect the pilot to do his job, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. Fly that plane.
Right? I mean, I do. I expect him to be professional. I expect him to go through the checklist. I want him to do everything. Mm-hmm. I don't want him to take a shortcut today, right? Because I'm on board. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Well, why are we not held to the same standards? Why don't we have to be awesome? Why don't we have to do everything right every time? You know? Mark Doyle says this is his job, this is his career, and this is his craft. The art of selling. Okay? You know, without us, I don't know where you work. Do you work? Where do you work?
Work for the National Guard.
Right. Okay. Thank you. I'm trying to think in just a second. Yes. Okay. Where do you work?
Well, I used to work for Walmart.
Yeah. Okay. You know, if it wasn't for salespeople, most of us wouldn't have a job. You know why, right?
Mm-hmm.
We don't need truck drivers. We don't need people working in manufacturers if there's nobody buying anything. If salespeople aren't selling, the economy stops, right? So look, if you say salesperson is not a noble profession, I'm sorry, but actually it keeps the economy going, right? We wouldn't even need most of the jobs if it wasn't for salespeople. So just depends how you look at it, you know. But when I leave the home and the customer says, it wasn't you, it was the rainbow that sold me, I say, awesome. Because they thought it was the rainbow that sold me. That's great. That's what I wanted, Angie. They don't know it was me. Okay, it's actually me. Okay, you know what I mean? Except this, Aaron sold that one. But yeah, okay. All right. Anyway, guys, so I talk about that, and I say, but there's one thing floating around in our homes that bothers us more than anything else, and this is dust mite. Have you ever heard of the dust mite?
I've heard of it, yes.
Okay, this is a picture of one right here. They're not that big, obviously. I'll tell you where we'd need a shotgun, not a rainbow. They're so small, 7,000 of them can actually fit on your fingernail. That's pretty nasty. But see, these are actually what cause most of our allergy. You know what? We're not allergic to the actual mite. It's going to gross you out. But Pam, we're allergic to the waste. You know what I'm talking about when I say waste?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know if y'all call it poop, number two, here, what, but yeah. Okay. Occasionally, guys said, we call shit here. Well, I, you know, they say that, I say, great, you're kind of my kind of guy. That's what we call too. Okay. But anyway, that's what we're looking at. There's a protein in our waste all humans are allergic to. All right? But you have any idea what dust mites eat? A lot of people think they eat dust because we call dust mites. That's what I said. Mm-hmm. Right? But actually, dust mites eat the bulk of my food is sloughed off human skin particles. See, every 28 days, our body sheds our labor skin. Where do you think highest concentration of dead skin, Jamie, would be here in your home? One place you lay down and spend 8 hours or not. As you lay there, you lay out, all that dead skin gets off in your mattress. And when you get up the next morning, it's like a big buffet just opened up for those dust mites. And that's why they live there. And of course, if they live there, they're going to poop there. And that's a lot of times why we wake up in the morning, we're all stuffed up and all that. All that's ever happened to you, okay? Now, let me ask you this. If I took my light outside, and we turned the light on outside, do you think we would see anything?
I probably would see a little cousin pollen.
What do you think? So I said the same thing. But actually, you know what? You won't. Think about this. You walk outside on a bright, sunny day, you don't see all that stuff floating in front of your face, do you? Terry, you know the reason that you do inside and you don't out? It's because every 24 hours, I don't know if you'll say Mother Nature or God. So he washes the air with the dew, the fire, the rain, some type of water. We'll pass through that air. Not will Jenny clean that air. If you walk outside at 5 in the morning, the grass is what, Pam?
There's dew on it.
It's damp, right? Yeah, can you stomp dust out of a mud hole?
Nope.
No, when dirt and dust gets wet, it stays, right? We used to wet down the ball field before we play ball. You ever seen that done?
Yeah.
Keep the dust down, okay? Let me ask you, or maybe after good rain, that's the best time, right, to go outside. Mm-hmm. But let me ask you this. When's the last time, Jamie, it's rained here in your home?
I don't
remember. Just let me ask you, what are y'all doing to get that out of your air?
Making.
How's it working?
Apparently not good.
Still there, isn't it? Okay. What if she says I got an air purifier? I say, how's it working? Exactly. Now you need to go get your garden hose. Everybody knows this. Get your garden hose, spray the air down, clean your air. That's the way who does it? God or Mother Nature passes the what through who?
Water.
Passes the water through the air. What Rainbow found a way to do is reverse that process. Instead of passing that water through the air,
Pass
the air through the water. Does the same thing without getting anything wet. I got some water right here out of your kitchen sink. If that were in a glass instead of something looks like a bedpan, would you probably have a problem drinking that water? Same where you make tea, coffee, cook with? Tara, that's clean water, right?
Yes.
Correct. Shine a light from top or bottom?
Top.
If I wanted it to look dirty, I'd shine it from the bottom because you can see there's still stuff in there. Yeah. So I want to make sure if it's looking clean to put the light from the top. Okay? Now I'm not even using a book. Y'all got a book to use. But you understand that the book's going to cost you sales because you're going to read and you're going to bore me. You need to quit doing that and start winging it. But you know, there's a way you can look at the book and do this, okay? You can just get right over here and you can talk about this. I didn't talk about how we seal dirty air in, you know, double insulated windows and doors here. But see, you know why I forgot all that? Because I'm winging it. So if you got your book, if I look at this page right here, you know what I'd say? I would say, the air inside your house is worse than it is outside. And you already know that. So if you...
That was a good time, yeah.
So if you just look at that, and you start talking about how we seal the dirty air in. Everybody's using double insulated windows, doors, making the homes airtight. But guess what we trapped inside our home? Dirty air. You know, years ago, you used to not hear anything on TV about allergies and stuff like that. Now it's a multi-billion dollar business. The reason is we're making our homes real airtight. If you took a creek and ponded up, Larry, you know, fresh water go in, no water go out, what would eventually happen to the little ponded area? It would become what?
Dry.
It would be stinky, stagnant, turn green, right? You know, that's what the air's done in our homes, is it's become stagnant. Everything in here is releasing chemicals, and we're breathing those same dirty chemicals over and over and over. I was like, talk about that on that page right there. And then flip over here and say, well, where does dirty and unsafe houses come from? Filth from streets, brought about our shoes. That's when I talk about all the stuff we walk through. Then I rate the light because I got a light there. The light tells me I should rate the light.
Them demo I done where I sold it, I missed both of them.
Did you? Okay. Well, you should rake the light when you see the little light.
Well, I was raking the light, but I wasn't. I didn't.
Why is it important to rake the light a lot, Tara?
So they can see.
So you're not just saying it, you're
proving
it.
They can be reminded.
So what does this whole first part do?
It makes them start thinking.
It creates what?
Problem.
A problem.
Yes.
It creates what?
A problem.
That they didn't know that they had. Now, we're going to show them, Rachel, in a minute, how we also have the solution to the problem, right? So you understand that you got to create a problem in order to have a need for a solution. And we're going to do it with facial expressions and smiling and moving around and using their first names and sitting close to them. And does that make sense? That's crazy. You're hearing our voice. All right. So anyway, I'm going to do the air wash next. I'm going to get done with all that. So I put the rainbow together. The rainbow has how many parts?
Two parts.
Bottom part holds the water, top part holds the motor, and you fasten them together with these little latches right here. Let me ask you a question. When y'all built this house, wouldn't it have been awesome? What? You'd have a switch over there on the wall. You could just flip the switch, and it would eliminate all of that. Wouldn't that be awesome, Beth?
Mm-hmm.
Would you use the switch if you had a switch that did that?
Absolutely.
Here's a switch. The rainbow right here. Takes all your dirty air right there in the front. See it going in there? Takes all your dirty air in the front, Pam. See that? Takes it through a swirling bath of water we call the rainbow hurricane. Would you agree if something goes in there, it's going to get wet? Where's the dirt and dust when it gets wet? It stays, right? Then it blows fresh water, washed air straight out the back. Doesn't it smell fresh? It's the freshest air you can bring your home. Just like walking outside after a rain. Should you blow it at them? Yeah, it wakes them up. That's why you do it. They worked all day. They're tired. They got to get the kids to bed. They got to brush their teeth. They got to cook dinner. You better wake them up, right? You let them feel the water. The power. You got to wake them up. Let everybody feel the power. Turn the rainbow off really quick. Rainbow's still what?
Brown.
Still running. And guess what's already underneath? The bulb.
Light.
The light. Why that fast?
So it doesn't set up.
The water looks worse right now than it will if we wait 30, 45 seconds or a minute and shine the light. It will not look as bad. The stuff on the surface is the dust. The stuff in the water is bubbles. Okay? I do not tell them that. I say, look at that, guys.
Look at the dirt.
I say, would you believe it?
It's nasty.
Would you drink that water now? And they say, well, heck no, I wouldn't drink that water now. You know, doctors tell us it'd be safer to drink it than to breathe it, because if we drink it, it will pass through our body. Iodine's in our stomach, acid in our stomach will pass, but what we breathe goes to our, and causes asthma, allergy, all kinds of breathing, because it ends up in our bloodstream, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Got me? Can y'all do that?
Great.
It's already settling.
See the difference? If you wait, it doesn't look as bad. So, and I'm not going to lie and say all that's dust. I just say, look at that, guys. Would you drink that water now? And they say, oh, Lord, no, honey. All that came out of my air. It sure did. See the difference?
Yeah.
Okay. So immediately, did I have the rainbow run on low or high?
High.
High, not low. Not low. Don't run the rainbow on low. Why would you run on low? So don't run away. So you want to basically put the rainbow together now and show them that about every day while we're brushing our teeth, taking a shower in the morning, we're running our rainbow on high for 20, 30 minutes. Do I yell? Yeah, the rainbow's running. I got to get them excited, right? So I'm going to talk a little louder here, right? But what it does, an average 1,500 square foot home, it'll clean all the air one complete cycle about every 15 minutes. Okay. Well, she got a big home here. See, you might need to run it for 30 minutes, okay? But what I love about the new rainbow, this is a new rainbow to E2. It has what's called quiet wash. Check this out, Jamie. You can leave it running 24 hours a day to clean it without ever having to turn it off, all right? We're still sitting here using no more electricity than a clock on your microwave or a DVR. But check this out, what it's still doing. Still pulling all that dirt, dust, and filth in that water, right? See this seal right here on the side? The rainbow is certified by the Asthma and Allergy Foundation. One of our guys, Zach, was in a demo not long ago, and the daughter had real bad asthma. And on her nebulizer, you know what seal was on there? That little seal right there. It's very difficult to get approved by the Asthma and Allergy Foundation. Our company's approved by them, and you know, there's a bunch of certificates in here. Y'all have seen that page, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and this page right here teaches you, shine light from the top, show the stuff being sucked in, let them smell the fresh air coming out back, let them feel the power, put light underneath the bottom. Did you know this was here?
Yes.
Pretty awesome. Okay. Can you flip right here and right here? Show them it's certified by AHIM, the company that certifies air purifiers. So in other words, you can't be considered an air purifier unless AHIM or some similar corporation certifies you.
What's AHIM say?
Association of Home Appliance Manufacturers.
Appliance manufacturers. Yeah. Okay. Now, this page reminds you to do what next?
Fragrances.
I'm putting fragrances in. Y'all do that, right?
Yep.
Okay. Now, I'll tell you one thing about the fragrances, though. He says, Philip says, more why. Let me tell you why you put the fragrances in, right? Or what you say about the fragrances. You got to get them thinking how they would use the rainbow if they had it, not what it does. Here's what I mean. If I had a rainbow and I put my fragrances in, I say, isn't that awesome? Let me tell you what we do. We have company coming over, like after church on Sunday, if our family comes over, you know what we'll do before they get here? Yeah, and we'll run it for 20, 30 minutes on high before they get here. You walk in our house, and it smells like orange. You know what they think we just finished doing? Clean. Exactly. You know the first thing you notice when you walk in someone's home?
The smell.
You do. You guys. Don't say that, okay? You feel like saying that sometimes. I've been home, so I'm like, we're going to get the fragrances really quick here.
Right? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, but anyway, then I'm going to go to the green deodorizer. What does this do? This what? One word.
Sanitize
would work, or disinfects. Either word would work. This actually does what? Kills
germs.
Did you know that? These don't kill germs. This one kills germs, all right? When you clean your house, do you use anything that says kills 99.99? Okay, that's this. That's on it. That's this, okay? What you can do with this, if someone's sick, you can run this, and I'll put some in, let them smell, and that smell just smells clean, right? It smells like, sort of like a hospital. That's because doctors and doctors' offices and hospitals actually pump this stuff into the ventilation system. Google it. It's called triethylene glycol. It's written right here on the side, okay? And it's actually, it does a couple of things. Number one, it kills airborne germs. Right? If you read online, you don't have to get real technical to customer because technical is not good. Okay, what's the rainbow made out of? Who cares? Who gives a crap what it's made out of?
American. That's all you need to know.
Okay, that's okay. But who cares what it's made out of? You got to talk about what it does. Hey, is that thing clean better than my vacuum? That's all they care about. All right? Not what it's made of, how many RPMs. What's the horsepower? I don't know.
Some people do ask.
I know they do. You just say, you know, that's not how a vacuum cleaner works. So let me show you. Now, when I get the mini vacuum, but anyway, it's 100 over horsepower, so it's 200 horsepower. You gonna do that? No. I don't know what it is. Just
ignore it. I know one thing that Michael did, like, that I like, that he did. He did it, like, it goes, like, 102 miles an hour.
The air coming
the same
in
as
100.
A, oh, yeah. Something, a hurricane, yeah. And then he did the lightning.
He
that's
made,
hilarious.
Yeah.
He made
all of that. Yeah. He made all of that.
He's good. He's so full of it.
No, it's all true.
He's good.
It's 120, I think.
It is 120.
120 is the air going into the machine. We've got an anemometer, you know what that is? Right? At our office in Morganton. An anemometer.
And it,
how fast the winds move. And we put it here, and it's over 120. Okay, which is a category, whatever.
22.
Two.
Anyway, yes, I said. But anyway, guys. This is awesome because this disinfects kills germs. What I also like is it eliminates every. You ever cook fish, cabbage, broccoli?
Mm-hmm.
Now again, now I got her thinking. You know, every week we cook.
Wow.
Whatever, right? She might say, "Oh, do you? Okay,
cabbage,
we painted a room in our house one time, and it's actually eliminated the paint smell. It was oil paint. Check this out. You smoke? And they say, "No, yeah, huh?"
I think.
This, what's that saying?
Smoke. They say yes or no.
Yeah. If they smoke, I don't say much about this, but if they don't smoke, I say, you've been around somebody who smokes and you know you get that smell in your clothes. Well, if it's something that you